When we were considering to put these early records on our label, we of course were pushed by the urge to find a roots, the very beginning of Czech industrial scene. So we were looking for material from the early 80s, which was somehow focused or which represented the core of industrial music scene back then in a former socialist Czechoslovakia. And of course, how it usually is in a project like that, we came on the question, who was the first Czech or Czechoslovakian industrial artist? And surprisingly, there were not just one, there were two in the early 80s. On one hand, it was Jarda Palát and Slávek Kvi working together before Slávek's departure to Ireland, or let's say its immigration. And independently, in the early 80s, around the Liberec University, we discovered also Interpretace.
Thank you. té době vlastně bylo nahraný to, co vydal to Blues Europa Café.
In the 80s, they were playing the album which the Old Europe Cafe published, released.
That's the one with the big red building on the front of it? What's the significance of that big red building?
Ten obal, vlastně to je ta budova v Německu, jo? A ten obal dělal pravděpodobně někdo asi v Itálii, protože to je neautorizovaný vydání.
The album is unauthorized. He's assuming that the red cover was made by some Italian who was collaborating with the old Europe Cafe. It has nothing to do with Interpretace, they have no influence.
Tato nahrávka se dostala přes kamaráda k někomu, kdo to poslal tam, a my jsme o tom prostě vůbec nevěděli, až do vlastně roku někde.
As Richard was saying, he gave the recording to a friend, and from his friend it came in other hands, and the guy who was at the end here sent it to Italy, and they decided to make this recording, and it was unauthorized, so Interpretace had no influence, and they discovered that this recording exists. This doesn't really do it. Thank you.
Second very important source for their music, or even for the information that they have ever existed, was the catalog of the Italian label Old Europa Cafe, run by Rudolfo Proti, who put on in early 80s, among his very first releases actually, the tapes acquired or published by Mikuláš Chadima of MCH band called Informator or The Informer. When we started looking and excavating these early tapes, we discovered that Interpretace were among the first projects on that tape, and it was pretty surprising to find out that they were performing some kind of very raw and very, let's say, natural industrial music. And this was the reason why we started excavating Interpretace's music and thinking about their releasing.
Thank you. zatím bez diagnózy. Tak co pak vám schází?
Poslušně hlásím, že mám reuma.
No to je opravdu náhoda dostat rehma, když je světová válka a člověk má jít na vojnu. To vás musí asi strašně mrzet, co?
Poslušně hlásím, pane Oberarzt, že mě to strašně mrzí.
A nebolejí vás kolena?
Poslušně hlásím, že bolej.
No my vás tady vyléčíme lépe než v Píšťanech a mašírovat budete na pozice, až se za vámi zapráší. Pište, úplná dieta, dvakrát denně vypláchnout žaludek, jednou za den klistýr, ale pořádný, až bude volat všechny svaté, aby se to rehma leklo a vybíjelo. No a teď vám dáme nějaké prášky. To vypijete hned.
Čábu.
You've talked about genius loci, and you've played it a number of really interesting places, like the Heretic Chapel. I'm forgetting, I can't pronounce the name of the church, and you told me about a concert you played at an industrial site. Mm-hmm. Is that an integral part of Interpretace, and maybe talk about that aspect?
Mm-hmm. Tak v té době prostě bavilo nás chodit i ven. Chodili jsme si většinou nějaké industriální právě věci, nebo když jsme někde akustiku našli zajímavou a tam jsme někdy...
Já to budu teda jinak to zapomněl. The guys went often for short walks around because they all have similar passion for industrial architecture, so they were looking or searching such places and they checked the acoustic and the acoustic was okay. Tak?
Tak jsme zkusili tam něco si zahrát.
So they tried to
některý z těch věcí byly i nahrané. Jako třeba gusle.
Jo. So some of the recordings like gusle were recorded in such a space.
Were these advertised concerts? Were they done with permission, or they done surreptitiously? Or?
Já jsem tam měl nějaký promo, nebo to bylo povolený, nebo se to zakázalo.
Řekněme, že nás to vůbec nezajímalo, že jsme se, jednak jsme se nikoho neptali. Dělali jsme si to, jak jsme chtěli, a dělali jsme to proto, aby jsme to někde předvali.
So they did it for themselves, and they more than often didn't ask anybody for permission, so it was... I don't want to say illegal, but it was okay. Not permitted.
Okay.
So after we discovered Interpretace's music that even existed and it was put on in early 80s by Rodolfo in his label, we then discovered that there were some tracks publicly available at the website archive.org. So Michal from our label, Michal Borůvka, got in touch with Richard Charvat about his music, because it was surprising for us too that back in 2010 Interpretace were still performing. It wasn't industrial music in itself, it was more like a experimental rock music or just guitar driven post music in general, but they were still performing, still under the same moniker, and we went in touch with them and asked them whether we can publish their early industrial material or not, and they actually agreed and told us that the situation in early 80s was a bit chaotic for them, because they never were asked officially to get their early material published, and they were pretty surprised that they see their own music published on Italian label, which actually no one is able today to tell how did this music or the early tape of Interpretace reached Rodolfo in northern Italy back then.
Shh.